Emily Riquette, and you're watching Amplify.
So, I mean, I started this entire online business thing not even trying to build an online business. I wanted to become a professional soccer player. I'm from Dominican Republic, lived there my entire life, and that's what I wanted. So I started social media because in my brain, I'm like, I live in DR. Nobody's gonna look for me over there. The country's not even known for soccer, it's known for baseball. So I gotta figure out some type of leverage to actually get out there. So I just started doing social media in 2011, 2012 with zero success whatsoever. Then I moved to the States in 2014, I don't even remember what it was. In 2016, I started seeing some traction, and that's how when it took off. And I had the chance to actually become a pro because of the social media. So I actually achieved the goal that I wanted, and that's when I decided to say no. People say all the time, like, follow your feelings, and I'm like, no, that's not true. Don't do that. Your feelings can change like overnight. Just take an analytical approach to something, take a calculated risk, and that's what I did, and now we are kind of here, so.
So what is your business?
Yeah, so I do Instagram marketing. Instagram marketing is kind of like what people know me for. I do marketing in general, you know, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, like all this stuff, but my core focus is Instagram, and that's what people know me for. Been grateful enough to work with huge clients like Lady Boss, Dan Lok, mm-hmm. a lot of Tucama Club ex-members. I consulted with Russell Brunson's team, like mm-hmm. ran campaigns for Ty Lopez, Gary Vee, like, so I've been to Grant Cardone's TV show twice, so it's like, it's been fun, it's a crazy journey. So yeah, that's what I'm known for to do.
All right, well, for all of us who are out there trying to grow our Instagram accounts yeah. or grow our businesses, and maybe we're not really paying attention to Instagram, mm-hmm. what are some of your best takeaways that we can implement?
Right so the very first thing I would say is that people think that they need a big following to grow their Instagram, but that is not true. You can monetize any Instagram account with 100 followers. It all comes down to building relationships. So people like, as marketers, you know, I'm a marketer mm-hmm. myself, we're all thinking like, oh, conversion rate, percentage, like seeing all these numbers and whatnot, but like we forget that every single number is a person too. So if you treat every single follower that you get, even with a small following, as a real person, you will make more money. So what I do, for example, for clients is we not only grow, obviously, but we monetize mm-hmm. and we, Instagram stories right now is just a humongous play, and people are not utilizing them correctly. So you can literally just go on Instagram story right now and create content that's valuable instead of posting your taco and like what you ate for lunch or your cat. Just
but that's so easy, and like yeah, tacos but, look delicious.
It's okay,
so
but I mean, like if you have a food blogger that's gonna make you money, then cool. Yeah. But I try to use Instagram as a business, not yeah. just. It's a 15-year-old girl, you know, like, so that's like what I do, and we could just create valuable content on Instagram stories, and then before we pitch, and this is the most important part, is we pre-frame the offer with polls. So for example, if you go right now to Lady Boss, you will see that they're asking questions all the time, pre-frame it with polls, and the reason is because if people voted yes or said yes, or they, you know, in a question they said, instead of saying, ask me anything, instead of doing that, say, what is your biggest struggle in their case with weight loss, or in my case, what is your biggest struggle with your Instagram marketing, or if you're in like, camping, what is your biggest struggle with when you go out camping? People will literally tell you their pain point and say like, okay, John, I just noted that your biggest struggle with camping is not being able to, I don't know, build a tent in 5 minutes. Here, look, there's a free course and this tent that I'm selling on Amazon just does exactly that. So it's like, it's a lot easier when you actually ask people. But at the beginning, yeah, you should like plan out, like just go to BuzzZumo, go to Google Trends, go to Quora, see what people are asking, see where people are like trying to find out and just create content around the topic. Like your expertise in fitness, camping, like marketing, doesn't matter. Just go there, see what people are searching for, and more than likely, people will also be interested on Instagram. You can create Instagram stories, Instagram TV, Instagram Live, the actual content on the page itself, and then that's the monetization, right? And then you're like, all right, cool, I'm making money now. How do you actually grow that? All right, cool, then just use distribution. So it all comes down to product distribution or content distribution. We have the content already. And then the distribution is literally can be Instagram ads or using influencer marketing campaigns, taking the content that's performing well on your page or what I call the BPPs, which are best performing posts, and taking that content and just posting on bigger pages that are in your niche, that are related to your stuff, that you know they have your target audience, and then driving traffic back to your page.
Well, how can you also help people find this? Let's say you're doing your lives, you're providing the valuable content, but you still only have a couple hundred followers. Mm-hmm. Is there a way to leverage hashtags or like what should we be doing?
Of course, so I always start, I always start with market research, always. I don't like whenever I'm working with a client or whatever, I always start with market research. And that's also, I have, you know, close to 1,000 students right now. Always start with the market research because it literally just tells you what you need to do. Like instead of trying to figuring out the perfect formula, just somebody else has it. Just like see it and model it. Just like, you know, when you're funnel hacking, that's what you're doing. So what I do is like, let's say for example, you're in fitness. Just type in the hashtag fitness and on Instagram, or just type in the main keyword, weight loss, whatever. See the top competitors, see the top influencers in the niche, and then see what content they're posting, when they're posting, what times they're posting, what calls to actions are they doing. They're like, hey, double tap, or is it more like asking questions, how their audience is reacting. And then you're able to see not only what content works, how to talk to your audience, what copy to use, but on top of that, you're also literally creating the distribution network that you're later on going to utilize. So you're like doing everything in just one sit with the market research, and then you just have the formula, the perfect strategy. You're like, oh, this guy did this. All right, what do I do?
Yeah.
Do exactly the same thing.
Insta hacking with the Insta boss.
Yeah, exactly. And it works like, for example, if you have a personal brand, like for example, if you saw, you know, an entrepreneur do a video about X topic and you're an expert in the same field, what do you need to do? Do the same thing,
yeah,
but in your own like little way, right? And let's say, for example, you have an e-com store, or maybe you're a little bit shy, you don't want to be in front of the camera. What do you need to do? Just see what the e-com brands or the theme pages, the main pages are doing on Instagram and do exactly the same thing. And then the beauty about it is that you can then leverage your following to get influencers for free, which is like what people don't get. Your following is like a digital asset, like a digital real estate, and it increases in value as time progresses. And what you can do, let's say for example, you have 10,000 followers or 100,000 followers today, you can then use that and get influencers to promote your products and services for free because in exchange to get promoted on your page.
Sure, because so they'll grow. It's a win-win.
Exactly.
All right, this is so good. Where can we go to find you and learn more?
Yeah, so I'm all over the place. I just search Josue Pena, or you can go to igboss.com. We also have, that's a free complete masterclass where they can start. We actually teach them with only 3,000 followers how you can make over $160,000 in 1 year. With only 3,000 followers, so a very small following, and then make over a six-figure income from that. We also show that in that masterclass, and then show them how to grow and all that stuff. And then we also have a YouTube channel, Online CEOs, which is the brand name, or people can search my name, Josue Pena. And you know, we can more than happy to help.